Hello, welcome to the stream with me, TapersCrazy. We are back with some more of the last story, and where we last left off with this game, we commandeered. Is commandeered the right word? I mean, we murdered a lot of Garak and stole their boat off them. I guess in essence, it's still kind of commandeering, but we did engage in an act of piracy, I suppose. But with this boat, we're deciding to chase the Garak fleet down after they laid siege to our home city. And I don't know what the end goal is. I guess we're going to murder some of them, or at least see what it is they're up to. Just so we can go back with some intel. But before we did that, we helped Marania with her expedition onto this island that we've encamped at. Nearly got killed by a giant spider, kicked a wall through, and found out that the guardians of the world are dying, which is what's causing all these white flakes you see on the screen. That's not actually snow or cherry blossoms or anything. That's the land dying. And I guess one avenue of the game is to figure out why. But alas, that's where we got to, and I believe one of our quest mates, Yurick, one of our party members, I should say, Yurick, also has an interest in exploring this island, so let's go see if we can see what it is that he's up to. No doubt more exploring difficult areas and getting murdered by a boss enemy, but c'est la vie, that's JRPGs. hello, Tasha, welcome to the stream. Thanks for dropping by, giving me some of your precious Tuesday evening. Yes, we do need a stand for our plaque, because for my birthday, Tasha got me this. It's like a little plaque which you can put on at the start of the stream. It's got my Twitch and Twitter tags on there, so that's very nice. Yeah, something to prop that up in front of a camera might be good. And hello, Aaron, welcome to the stream. Thanks for giving me some of your precious Tuesday evening. How are you doing, friend? How are you doing? I hope you're doing well. Hopefully you've not read 52 books since the last stream. Although, I wouldn't blame you if you did. Right, where's Yurick? Yurick. Although, I could upgrade some armor, because I was getting my pie was getting an absolute ass ripped out of them. In the last stream. I get a feeling it's because the armor's just not that great. Right, you're an item shop owner. Don't speak to Dargren. I guarantee he will advance the story. Because that's the way that his... whenever he interacts with Dargren, just story advances. Zale's not the main character Dargren is. We're just controlling side character. It's all about Dargren. I know you, alright, just cooking tea. What's on the menu? What's on the menu? Yes, I am very good, thank you. It's been a nice Tuesday. I had a haircut today, so I am very well, thank you. Right, well, I've done Mirania's quest. I imagine we can speak to Mirania to...
Oh, Tail. Why didn't you tell me you were going out onto the island? I would have loved to have come too.
Callista, there were monsters everywhere. I couldn't put you in that kind of danger.
We could have done with a healing or extra damage, you know, Zale.
I see I'm being treated like a little princess even outside the castle.
Mexican beef loaded wedges. I will have 4,000 of them, please.
That's not what I...
I'm only joking. I'm grateful enough that you've agreed to take me along at all. Thanks to you and your friends, my wish has already been granted. I'm happier than I've ever been before.
Aww.
Perhaps this is the point where I should prepare an official proclamation of gratitude?
I would be honored, milady.
Oh, these two are so cute. You touch your kiss. New recipe, you'll let me know. Ooh. Aaron's been experimenting. Everybody get down! I demand to see pictures on Discord or Snapchat or something. Right, what the bloody hell? There's cats all over this boat. I don't really understand why, because this was a Garak warship. Unless they've been capturing cats as well. Who knows? Could have done. We could have done. Ah, hello.
Come again.
Oh no, it's upgrades that I'm after. Hello. No, I'm as good as I'm gonna get. I need like gnome silver and stuff. Okay, I think I'm gonna be taking Yurick. Aaron says, my food doesn't look as aesthetically pleasing as Tom's. It's functional. Right, hang on. Let me see... what we can equip on... our good friend, Yurick here. Wait, the Brave Armor gives the same stats as the Heavy Armor. Right, Magic Defense. Does it increase Magic Attack, though? Oh, bloody hell. Light Grease that provide excellent Magical Defense. I mean, you'd think your casters would be more, they get more magic damage, they get more range damage to them, I suppose. It's magic attack that I'm after improving, though. Alright, sure, what's the worst that can happen? Let's upgrade that. Many disagree. It doesn't look too good, just tastes good. Many disagree, but you respect their opinion. However, they are most strong. Oh, I've already got some Brave Greaves plus one. I'll just equip those greaves onto Yurick. Got no idea if what I'm doing is actually remotely useful. There we go. Okay, shall we go?
Yurick, where are you going?
For a walk.
A walk? You don't know what kind of monsters might be out there. It's too dangerous to go alone.
You worry too much. I can handle myself.
No, you can't. You're a squishy.
It's only natural that I'd be worried. Why are you being like this? Can't you at least tell me where you're going?
There's a shipwreck out there. I want to investigate it.
A shipwreck? You into boats or something?
What does it matter to you?
Oh, man. I love boats. I'm coming too.
What? Don't be ridiculous. This is my... a problem, not yours.
I told you. It's too dangerous out there on your own. I'm coming whether you like it or not.
Yeah, man, if you go out there and die, then we're down a magic caster, so... and you're the ones which do most of the damage. So, I'm sorry, but this is purely for selfish reasons.
Fine then, whatever. But don't expect me to wait up for you if you start slowing me down.
Bloody angsty teenagers.
Then I'll make sure I don't.
Alright, is it just going to be me and Yurick, or did we invite the whole party? Hello, Killer Rosebud, pee pee poo poo. Thanks for dropping by, giving me some of your precious
Yurick.
Tuesday morning.
What?
How are you doing, friend?
Hidden beneath the island, the wrecked ship lay. Judging by its rotting hull, it could have been there for an eternity.
Oh, well, we found a boat. Not much. How about yourself? I'm doing good, thank you. Having a really chill Tuesday. I love having a week off work. Instead of doing work, you worry about all the work that's not getting done while you're away.
Maybe we can go this way. Yurick, wait here. I'll check it out.
And now, your song lyrics of a day with Kuro's book.
Wait!
If it's not the song that we've done in Hello the Boss, then I'll be very disappointed. Right. You're tripping balls. Alright, okay. Please tell me I'm not gonna get killed by everything in here. Yeah, it was really good. One thing I really liked about Hello the Boss episode 6, I think it's called Hell of a Boss, but I keep doing. It's because there's a wrestler called Sami Zayn who's finishing moves the Hello the Kick. It's actually spelt the same way, like Hell of a Kick. Hell of a Boss. But one thing I find fascinating about it is that episode 6 really brings home. Like, some of the episodes are a bit kind of ha-ha, hee-hee, little bit jokey, funny. But this episode just shows the entire cast as ruthless murder demons. Which I think's really... I really enjoyed. Just a bit of action, you know?
Zale!
Ooh, spooky bag. And not only that, but they all truly care about each other. Yeah, they're a pack of misfits, aren't they? Uh-oh. They're gonna be monsters!
Sail!
That is a big boy! Yeah, get on top of these things to kill them, I see.
See? Aren't you glad that I'm here?
Hey, I never asked you to come with me, remember?
Oh, don't expect me to remember how the tunes went. I watched it about 30 minutes ago, so... And for some reason, I just can't remember character names at all. My brain just discards that information. Why, Moxie? Why have you held your true feelings inside? I'm scared of rejection. Why, Moxie? Why do you have Millie put it? Oh, excuse me. Yeah, it gives me an erection. Hey! good song, though. Oh, if those are the only enemies we're facing, this should be hopefully pretty straightforward. There they got Rickrolled by Killer.
Yurick! Stupid crab, just save your strength. I can feel the poison. Mirania isn't here. What now? There could be an antidote around here somewhere. Stay here. I'm gonna go and look for one. I'll be back soon. Don't keep me waiting too long.
Goddamn poison crabs!
I don't plan to.
This is why you should always make sure that your seafood's properly cooked before you eat it. Because seafood is lethal.
I'm the only one who can save Yurick. I have to do something. I can't waste any time. There must be an antidote.
That's why I always try and avoid seafood options at restaurants like the plague.
Whoa.
There's a chest over here. Oh, that was a reference to episode 3. Oh no, it's been a while since I watched the rest of them as well, though. Gotta go on a binge now. Every time we release an episode, you've got to go on a binge. Should probably do that. Yeah, pirate ring. That's upgrade material, so that helps out Yurick, I think. So what are you up to today, Killer? You're streaming today. Did your what is it, the microphone guard come today? Got some more, you got some auditioning to be doing. Why does all the doors on this boat open in the most impractical way possible? It's so absurd. Wizard Slayer. All I need is somebody antidote, man. Pirate ring. Upgrade materials. That's going to be the door that we have to progress through because I can't open it right now. How can you roll in this armor? Oh, there's another chest. Aaron sent me an exclusive picture as food as requested. Oh, let's open it on stream. I'm not, don't worry. I'm going to look at it on my phone. Oh, man. You should show Tasha that. It'll make her really hungry. I will go help Yurick, but loot. And Yurick's a bit angsty, so he can wait patiently. Green clover? Right, I think that's everything. Bit odd that there won't be anything in this room. I love the ambience. Like, whoever done the sound design on this game did such a bloody good job. Because, like, you can hear, like, the boat creaking and stuff, and it's just really... Admittedly, you guys probably can't hear it as well over the sound of my name babble. But it just really sets the tone of this area of the game. It's almost like a haunted shipwreck. Enjoy your food, Aaron. Enjoy your food. Do you know one thing I found out? Actually, let me just do this cutscene before I continue my babble.
Yurick, how are you doing?
Looks like I owe you. I'll pay you back somehow.
No, forget about it. I mean, I can't count how many times your magic has saved me.
That's my job. It's what I'm paid for. But you're only here because I made a big fuss about it. It's not the same.
We're friends, right? It's normal to help each other. Right. Up you get.
Oh, shit, it hell. So no one told your life was. Right, okay, come on, you.
Let's climb up here. Try not to push yourself, okay?
And now your actual song lyrics of the day. With Killer Rosebud. I want to regale you with a tale, the continued tale of my getting my car fixed. It's only a little bit, but it just seems like there's nothing but an armada of cutscenes. What now?
Yurick, did you hear something just now?
Nothing.
Poltergeist?
Two of them.
Eat this! Yurick, hold
fire!
Stop! It's me!
Dagrin, why are you here? Marania too!
Why am I here? Why are you here?
I'm so glad that you're both safe. I was getting so worried about you.
Well, Yurick, are you going to tell them why we're here?
Forget it. I'm sure you have your reasons. It's pretty narrow up ahead. Let's split into two teams. Zale, which door do you want to take?
I pick number right door.
Then I'll take the left. Zale, you're on the other side. Mirania, you're with me. Yurick, go with Zale.
Yeah, but we still heard some, like, laughing, though. So, I don't think it was Dagra. Maybe it could have been Mirania, but I don't think it was. Well, I'm nervous now.
Bit of a squeeze. Really reminds me of clambering through back alleys as a kid. We can't get through here. Yurick, can you break the barrel?
Zale, out of the way.
Yeah, I activated my ability to speed up his casting. The one true boss fight in this game. Barrels. Is there actually something in here that we need? Oh, can we run up this thing? No. There's a notice board. I guess that's some sort of staff rota. Bill, I'm sorry, but you're working the 7 till 7 shift. Oh, well. That door looks... that looks like a hidden door. Do you not think with the different... Did I choose the wrong way? Hang on, let me see if I can head back to where Dagon and Mirania were. Oh, thank you very much for the host killer. Oh, and you put your lyrics in there. Dragged you down below, down to the devil show, to be his guest forever. Peace of mind is less than never. Hate to twist your mind, but got it on your side. An old acquaintance severed. Burn the world, your last endeavor. Flesh is burning, you can smell it in. Ooh, flesh is burning. I was just watching Below Deck Mediterranean, actually, and the chef on that boat just singed his flesh off his finger. That wasn't pretty. Like, really, really bad blister. Because men like you have such an easy soul to steal, so stand in line while they ink numbers in your head. You're now a slave until the end of time here. Nothing stops a madness turning, haunting, yearning, pull the trigger. You should have known the price of evil, and it hurts to know that you belong here. Yeah. It's your fucking nightmare. and you do want to hear about my cat, and also want to hear every little detail you heard and saw in Hoover Boss. yes, it is something that I found out yesterday whilst I was under the painful beating of the shower head, is that whilst I was sat waiting for the car to be done, I got sunburned because I completely forgot that sun burns you once you're standing it. So, like, it hurt like hell, but I don't know if anyone noticed on yesterday's stream, I look like bloody Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Every time, Zale! Oh, again? Oh, is he just gonna kick through every bloody... Zale! You're ruining the structural integrity of a ship. So yeah.
Zale, I'm going ahead.
I look like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer yesterday on stream. Do I do today? I might do because I've had a haircut, so like my face might be red, but like the outlines will be white. I'm like a poorly photoshopped shape. Ooh, known copper. Good. I mean, I'm white, so it's hard to notice me being sunburned. And the lighting of my...
Watch out for their poison.
Well, firstly, I found that was a bit unfair of a game to, Oh, there we go. We kicked its ass! Fucking Brit boy, whiter than I am. You are whiter than I am, I will admit. I do... Then again, two mates in the sun and I burn and tan, so it's, Ooh. Is that Dagon down there? It looks like, oh, the Skellingtons. Well, ripples, I suppose.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Is everybody okay?
I'm just waiting for command to get ready. Power strike. Oh wait, Mirani, you died. The Muse. Get her up. There we go. Didn't actually get any of those ones where we jump on top of them, but it'll do.
Is this the ship's name? It's so dirty, I can't read it.
There's no need to read it. I already know. This is my father's ship.
Your father's?
He was the greatest sailor on the whole island.
Plot twist.
Every day he set sail before the crack of dawn. He protected our island. I was always really proud of my father. I remember it was a freezing morning, and the fog was incredibly thick. That was when pirates attacked our island. All the men went fearlessly to protect the village. But my father never returned home. There were rumors that he knew about the attack and fled for his life. But I couldn't believe them. I didn't want to believe them. But secretly, I always asked myself, what if he did run away? Me and my mother had to leave the village after that. It was a brutal journey. And while we were traveling, my mother, she died.
Yurick, forget the rumors. What do you believe? Did he run away?
I don't know, but I have to find out.
Then let's go. There's got to be some clues left. We'll find out the truth.
Is this a dead end?
No. The captain's quarters are definitely here somewhere.
Oh, well, there you go. Killer Rosebud says, you asked Mama Rosebud to make some chicken cordon bleu. Which is tasty. She turns the oven on, puts them in there, and forgets about them. That sounds like something I'd do. They didn't get too burned, but they're like bricks now. They're like hockey pucks. Wait, isn't this a weird place to have a helm, because you can't see where you're going? It's not like a starship where you can mount cameras on the outside. Ooh, treasure. Yeah, don't mind if I rob your father's ship. This is my father's ship. He ran away during a fight from pirates. Well, let's rob him then. Ooh, we have a recipe here. Recipe needs... Oh, that looks so... It's like a Parmo, but wrapped up. Almost like a Kiev. Although, I don't think Kiev has meat in it. It's just like chicken with a bit of a hollow bit and like garlic sauce in the middle. I think. Unless you can have different types of Kievs. Right, where was I going? I was going to go up the ladder, wasn't I? I don't know, I guess I can... come back and around. I am surprised that these guys aren't making... So if I went Dagrun's route, I would have had to deal with all this mess. That doesn't sound particularly fun. It's cheese and breaded chicken. It's fucking delicious. I'll have to try and make some someday. Or ask Tassia to try and make some. There's definitely something following us. It's like Resident Evil. Alright, there we go. You can buy pre-made ones. Oh, you must start Stolas, the big owl guy.
What's this smell?
The episode also showed the sort of power that he possesses as well.
Camorra shrimp stew and roast pheasant in campo sauce. Oh, and they're served with some freshly baked whole wheat bread.
You can tell that from here. Wow.
Bit of a foodie, isn't she, Mirania? It also makes me wonder, is why does Stolas need the book every now and again? Because it's just demonstrated that he's got the ability to come into the human realm just at will. I guess as part of that, he might have to possess someone to do it, though. Because he did have to get vomited up by the bone of ladies.
A table served. Wait, that means someone's still alive.
Oh,
Stolas.
Oh, please.
Don't think about it, Mirania. It might be poisoned.
More to the point, who cooked it? Ooh! Mirror, mirror on the wall.
Dad! Yurick!
I guess he's still young. Maybe we don't know Yurick as well as we think we do.
Yeah, the living world aren't supposed to know demons exist. Well, they're about to, because they're all on camera now. Makes me wonder if at some point Lucifer's going to get involved then. I don't know where Lucifer fits into the grand scheme of things. I know he's the king of all hell. When does it get to the CEO level, you know? What's the next escalation point?
This must be it.
Lucifer is Charlie's dad, yes. You don't take shit from other demons. Right, okay.
Yurick, are you okay?
No doubt about it. Dad. This is Dad's writing. It's been a week since we've been adrift. We still haven't seen land.
And the crew are in a terrible state. No mast. No rudder. The ship is like a huge coffin, bobbing up and down on the waves. All hope is lost for us.
So Dad was shipwrecked. But how? Why? The skies were totally clear.
I think there's something more sinister at play here. We don't know what Stolas's job is exactly, but it involves moving between worlds constantly. So if Stolas needs to possess people constantly to do his job, people have known about his demons, and in particular Stolas, long ago. Yeah, beyond the hearsay, crude finger painting drawings in books and stuff. Ooh. Uh-oh!
Is it me?
Watch this!
What now? Whereabouts is he? In the middle somewhere? Power strike. Right, I'm gonna get her just to put down heal circle.
This is our big chance. Or maybe it's just a chance. Zale, let him have it.
Okay, I think I need to use the flares in. How does this fight work? Eternities of a thing from Shadow of the Colossus. Unhand me!
What are they? Why are they copying what we do?
Bet they made that fake food too. What the heck? Oops.
It's me. What's
it mean? It's like they're changing into us. What's going on? Pathetic. Close to you can see the difference. Even if they change, their eyes don't. If they go red, then the-
Ow! Oh. Whoops.
It's fine. Just watch it.
So we have to pay attention when we're fighting.
Hey, you know it's me, right?
Oh, come on! Alright, who's the enemy? I think that's my Marania. I'll get rid of the bad Marania. Right, hang on a minute. This fight really wasn't thought out with the auto controls. How do I change them? Options. Right, there's an option where I can switch off auto attack. It's convenient most of the time, but for this fight, it's absolutely ruining everything. Target line, HP gauge. I don't know if I can. Well, I don't think there's anything I can do about it. Oh well.
Hey, you know it's me, right? Hey.
Fail. Defuse my magic.
Oh come on!
Here I go.
Oh come on!
If you want me to cast reverse on their heal circles, just give the order.
You know it's me, right? Hey, you know it. Hey, you know it's me, right? Hey, you know it's me, right?
Man, like, this is so frustrating because I don't want to spend the entire stream going through menus trying to figure out how to turn off auto attack. Oh well, we're killing him. I don't know what broke my back on that fight, but they just all started dying. I won! I guess! Man, that's so frustrating, because that's like a mechanic of a game that I couldn't find out how to turn off.
Together, my men and I defeated that giant monster. And of this, I am truly proud. I think some other monsters headed towards the island. But I have good faith that the villagers fought them away. However, the foul monster we bested was of a different caliber. No one could have faced it but us. Though no one in the village will ever know, my men and I fulfilled our duty as warriors. And so I leave behind this, my final log. If someone should read this, I implore you to let the villagers know of our fate. Tell them we fought bravely until the bitter end.
And please tell my beloved wife and son. The two of you were in my thoughts until the very end. And I love you dearly. Father. Dad. He died to protect us. I finally learned the truth about my dad. Thank you.
Every time Yurick smiles, the puppy dies. Oh! I'm sure he's found peace though now. He even looks like his dad, the same hairstyle.
Everything changed for Yurick that day. His cold and cynical heart finally began to warm, thanks to his father's words and the kindness of his friends.
We all learned a valuable lesson.
With a smile of genuine gratitude, Yurick started to come to terms with his past.
We all learned a valuable lesson about these stuff and the things. Right, let me actually see if I can equip that to Yurick. Memento dagger. It's got less from the dagger plus 5. Only a little bit though. Hang on. So I've got one third. Oh, it just tells you how much it goes down by. 406 from 456. I'm gonna see how much it'll take to upgrade it. Killer Rosewood asks, so Luna fighting, thoughts? I thought that scene looked like an absolute nightmare to animate, to be honest. but no, it was really, really, really good. Her hair was so wavy. Alright, pirate ring. Another pirate ring. And now I need noble rings. Hey, why are you talking like that? Cause you my little bitch boy, and you are dripping balls. that was actually really good seeing that though. When he's going up the stairs and it's like Phantom of the Opera or something like that. Oh, hello. Hey, you know there's a door below deck with one open? Ah, fixed it. Woo! Yeah, I know. I don't. But what is in here? Loot?
Whoa. What is this?
Books!
Was all this stuff looted from Lazarus Island?
One guy just picked up a bookshelf. You know, I'm taking this.
This is a pretty old book. I've never even seen symbols like this before. A picture of Lazarus Castle. What could this book be about? What the? This is the same symbol that's on my hand. But who is this person?
Is she gonna kill me? What's going on?
Sail, what are you doing? This book, it came from the castle. I've seen it before.
Then do you know who this person is?
I think he's my distant ancestor. That's what my father said.
So you're related?
Yes. The founder of the House of Arganin. He was supposedly a very powerful sorcerer. The legends say that he borrowed the power of a god to create the Lazarus Cannon. And that he used it to banish the Garak, putting an end to the suffering they caused.
Did you say a god?
Well, maybe not a god exactly. I don't really know the details. Only that it was referred to as the Outsider.
The Outsider?
Huh. Yet it pleases me that a human, too, has come to possess the Outsider's power.
That mark? It's the same as my ancestors.
Yeah. And since I got that weird mark, I've been able to use this strange power. Zangarek mentioned it too. He called it the Outsider's power.
Right. So maybe that's why your light was shining so brightly back then. Could it have been reacting to my Arganum blood?
I'm just a mercenary. Why would I have that kind of power?
Could it be to protect Lazarus Island from the Garak, just like in the legend? I'm sure the Outsider believed you'd be able to do that.
That doesn't make sense. Zangarak had this power too. Do you think Zangarak knows something about what this power really means?
I think he knows everything. Wow. Well, there you go. I have the power of a god. It just smashes his hand into the ground and summons Obelisk the Tormentor. Because that's what Kyber does. Oh. Oh, another pirate ring.
I wonder what that key you found is for.
Well, it said it was for a cabinet, so... But I imagine the cabinet would be back at base, wouldn't it? Back at Lazarus Island. Right? I don't recall seeing any other cabinets here. But Killer says the thing where Blitz is talking about one's fat mama and then they go, she's dead. They did make Blitz make a joke about that being like, exactly, that's why I had a good time with her last night. I thought that as well. I was like, it was open season on that. If she went to hell, I suppose.
Now, where was it?
Oh, I see.
There are scratches around this cabinet. Maybe it can be moved.
Okay. Behold!
What's this map?
The map that Zael had found showed the precise location of the Gurak's frontline military base.
It's hard to believe that they managed to secretly gather so many warships this close to Lazarus Island.
Over a century has passed since the Gurak were banished from the Empire. We humans have grown careless.
It gets worse, too. For the first time, the Gurak are united under a powerful king, Zangarak.
He's to blame for all this.
The ship's repairs are almost complete. As soon as we're ready, we'll head for the Gurak base.
And the what? One boat. Well, take them all down. I mean, that is actually a pretty serious tactical blunder by whoever owned this boat. They should have burned this as soon as they knew that they was getting attacked. Looks like that's just key tactical information that they just let us have.
Charging into an enemy base. It's like we're brave knights out of a fairy tale.
There's a fine line between brave and stupid.
Charging into an enemy base. It's like we're brave.
You ready?
I guess.
Four of us will infiltrate the base. Myself, Zael, Yurick, and Lisa. Mirania, you stand by to take action if anything happens to us.
Understood. I will pray that my assistance is not called for.
Or maybe instead of brave knights in a fairy tale, protagonists in a video game. Anime protagonists!
Directions, the group set sail for the Gurak base. All of them treasured these last moments of calm in the face of the inevitable struggle to come. As the evening sun lingered upon the horizon, it cast a deep fiery glow across the seas and skies ahead. Like an infant's cradle, gently rocking from side to side upon the calm ocean waves, the ship sailed smoothly onwards towards its destination, its course straight and true.
Yay! And then it turns into a Poseidon adventure when a rogue wave tips us upside down.
How far does it go on? If I'd stayed in the castle, I could never have witnessed a sight like this.
Seeing you smile like that makes me happier than anything.
Ah, to be young and in love.
What made you decide to become a mercenary?
Well, back when I was still a kid, just after my village had been burned down, that was when I met Dagrin. The two of us got by for a while on our own, but one day Dagrin said, "We can't go on like this forever. We have to show the world what we can do, and make a proper life for ourselves." As it turned out though, the mercenary life wasn't much better. We have to become real knights.
But if you do become a knight, you'll be stuck inside the castle the whole time. You won't be able to see sights like this anymore.
You really aren't looking forward to going back.
No. But I don't want to cause any trouble for you or your friends either. I have to be strong too.
I wish there was something I could do.
It's all right. You've done more than enough already.
Politics. The cause of many problems.
Get a move on. We can't get caught here.
Sounds like the dragons from Game of Thrones.
Dive.
Yurick military base. Oh, we're gonna go Metal Gear Solid on this ship. Did you ever tell me about the shout out clip player setup? You know me and guards around this commands.
But who knows where they're hiding. Proceed with caution. Don't forget this is an enemy base.
I never have commands set up.
Yes, I'm fine. This water's really warm, isn't it?
The sea is above a line of volcanoes. They must be heating the water.
Wow. You know a lot, Yurick.
Not really.
No, I just peed in the water. Great minds think alike, killer. I'm just gonna go away and take a quick break. I'm gonna go pee in some water. No, I'm not. Right, okay, I'll be back in a few minutes.